see how anyone, unless maybe there were two people, I don't see how anyone could overpower him.
A taped phone call with Jodi Arias by the Mesa homicide detective investigating the murder of her ex-boyfriend, Travis Alexander. As it would turn out, Arias herself is now accused of the 2008 murder. She claims it was self-defense. The prosecution calls it a vicious, brutal attack. Good evening, Arizona. I'm Patty Kirkpatrick. Whatever you believe, there is no doubt this trial is a blockbuster. The media attention has been immense and intense. Crystal Cruz was in the courtroom today with dozens of other journalists. Crystal?
That's right, Patty. All of these reporters and journalists had their notepads, cell phones out, listening closely to all of the information that's being passed around in court, and then, of course, turning around and sharing it with the rest of the country.
We've got to warn you, the way the defense attorney in her opening statement describes Jodi and Travis's alleged interactions, it's very graphic and very sexually explicit.
HLN's Jane Velez Mitchell was showcasing what could be the trial of the year on her show last night.
I can totally see her committing a murder.
Nancy Grace also weighing in on the 32-year-old accused murderer. National networks are parking their rigs outside of the courthouse in downtown Phoenix. Everyone's watching and waiting to see the drama unfold in the death penalty trial of Jodi Arias.
Phoenix is a really weird news town on trials like this.
Criminal defense attorney Dwayne Cates, who is not representing anyone in the Arias case, is one of those paying close attention. He'll be making the network rounds himself. Of special interest to him, the jury.
Mostly older people, mostly Caucasian. There may have been one person of color in the jury, but that might have been it. And that's not unusual in Maricopa County.
There are 7 women and 11 men on the jury.
Typically, men are less empathetic than women, more likely to hand down a death penalty than women jurors were.
Kate says if he was handling this case, he would like to see more women in the jury box. 6 are actually alternates. Also in the courtroom were reporters and journalists from around the country. There were just a handful of seats left open in the courtroom to see what's now turning into a media circus. And of course, this trial is open to the public, but of course, seating is limited. Reporting live in downtown Phoenix, I'm Crystal Cruz for 3TV.